Brett, thank you so much for the time. How you doing today?
Doing great. Glad to be with you, Trey.
Yeah, it's always a pleasure. And man, it's just, I feel like this is every season, every college football season, but it feels like this year has flown by. How has this college football season been for you, considering that you're not only traveling around the Big 12, attending games in person, you were at the game here in Austin last Friday. There's a lot else going on across the college sports landscape as well.
100%. I mean, it's been a great season. As you and I have discussed before, you know, I try to get to every campus at least once. Certainly see all the teams at least once, if not more. So I've been spending my weekends on campuses, but also addressing some of the other issues, you know, that, you know, collectively the industry is facing. But it's been busy. It's been great. Excited about Champ Weekend. Got a lot in store. Two great teams. So I think it's going to end in a real positive note for the conference, and just excited to be here and a part of it.
Yeah, big announcement on the Big 12 championship game a couple of weeks ago. The player of the game actually gets to wear the WWE belt. Have you held the belt? Have you tried the belt on yourself? Is the belt in the office right now? What's going on there?
Oh, I'm going to see that belt for the first time tomorrow. We're excited. You know, I've said this, I think, to you before. We look at the calendar every year. We identify 10 poll events. Obviously, our championship football game is a big milestone marker and a huge 10 poll event for us. And to the extent we can, you know, promotionally elevate and amplify everything we're doing, bring greater attention to our schools, our student athletes, you know, I feel it's incumbent upon me as the commissioner and our conference office to do that. So the partnership with WWE, we're extremely excited about. You know, they reach over 150 million fans on social media, and they're promoting TuneIn. Obviously, we'll have, you know, some of the WWE superstars with us. In fact, today I'll be doing a community event with them in advance of Champ Weekend, and you know, again, they'll be with us on Saturday. So excited about that. You know, we're introducing the first ever halftime show, live on ABC with Nelly. What I love about it is Nelly's integrating himself with the school bands, and I think that's a big move for us. I know a lot of other conferences are going to watch because, you know, they want to turn these major moments into huge experiences for the fans. And there's been a lot of conversation about how do you address halftime. I think one of the concerns about it was, what do you do with the bands? They've been such a big part of it. And Nelly wanted to embrace that and do some things alongside the band. So should be great for the students, great for the audience. And, you know, that is here in Arlington and then ultimately those at home. So we're excited for all the things that are going on for the game this weekend. And then obviously having two great teams to play it out. Should be a big moment for us. We announced a sellout earlier this week, which was great. And so we'll have a packed house, a lot of passion in the building, and I'm just excited to be a part of it.
So I didn't want to get too deep into this interview, Brett, without addressing the elephant in the room for Longhorn fans, because back in the preseason, you were visiting, I think, pretty much every campus across your conference. And in speaking with fans at Texas Tech in Lubbock, you made mention of some things that really pissed off Texas fans, to be blunt about it. And to provide some context, when I heard what was said and how it was released and going back and listening over again, I, as a Texas fan, didn't have that big of an issue with it because I saw that in a sense that you were playing to the Tech crowd, but you were also showing loyalty to a school that is still going to be under your conference rule, I guess, is the best way to put it, after this season is over with and Texas and Oklahoma move on to the SEC. But a lot of Longhorn fans didn't feel that way. And as a matter of fact, a lot of people have held on to that comment all the way up to this point. I heard about it last week because you were obviously planning on being in town for the game itself. And even now, like after the game, players admitted that your comments were running on a loop in the weight room in the week leading up to the game as well. what was your experience like here in Austin on the field of DKR and then also in the stadium watching the game itself? Could you sense a sort of animosity from the Longhorn fan base as you were walking around and maneuvering your way through the Texas campus?
Well, Trey, I'm glad you brought it up. First of all, you're absolutely right. You know, I visit campuses often. And, you know, in the fall, I was at a donor event at Texas Tech, about 1,300 donors, and was playing to the crowd and really having fun. I mean, as you get to know me as a person, as the fans get to know me, of which many have, as I've been on campuses and been attending games, I'm a fun-hearted guy. You know, I was speaking to the crowd, obviously. And, I love being on campus last weekend. Had a great experience. I was on campus on multiple occasions last year in Austin. I saw a basketball game there. In fact, I was there. It was my third visit to campus. Every time I'm in Austin, I enjoy it. I was with my son. You know, the fans were great. And candidly, listen, I love the passion that the Texas fans have. One of the reasons I love the job I'm in is because I love the passion I see week to week going to campuses. On weekends, our fans wear that passion, and during the week they live it. And I think it's fantastic. And I've seen that dynamic since I've been on the job now for 15 months. And in fact, I think the passion I experience here is more than where I've worked before, whether it be in professional sports or not. So I love the passion. I love that the fans care. I'm a big fan of all of our schools. I have a good relationship, a great relationship with the coach, with the AD, with the president. I'm looking forward to embracing the fans this weekend and looking forward to a great game.
A lot of Texas fans felt like you coming out and admitting that you were rooting for Texas Tech over Texas in that final game of the season was unprofessional coming from a conference commissioner. Do you agree with that sentiment at all?
All I could say is I was having fun. I was speaking to the crowd. I treat everyone fairly. I love all of our members. I'm happy for Texas. You know, they've had a great season, a fantastic season. They're going to the SEC. It's something they wanted to do, and I'm excited for them. But at the same time, I'm excited for the future of the Big 12. As I said when I first took this job, you know, I saw all of this unfolding as a win-win for everyone. I look at life half full, not half empty. I always look at the positives in everything. And I've been happy, you know, for the Texas fans, the Oklahoma fans, wanted them to have a great season this year en route to their next chapter. And the conference is obviously on a good path forward. So I think everyone wins in this situation. And like I said, I'm happy to be a part of this weekend, happy to see the fans, those from Texas, Oklahoma State, and it should be a great, great day.
Did you know in the moment that those comments had a chance to go viral? Like, did you realize that there was a video camera on you and there was a chance that the Big 12 and what you were saying in that moment would become the talk of college football leading into week zero of this current season?
Listen, I you know, when I get into those moments and I'm having fun and, you know, in front of the crowd, I don't really focus on whether there's cameras or iPhones. Again, there's nothing more I can say. I love all our members. I'm a fan of all of our members. And I was having fun speaking to the crowd that I was in front of. And again, you know, enjoyed my time on campus last Friday and looking forward to seeing the fans this weekend.
All right, last question on this, I promise, and then we'll move on because there are some other important things to talk about. Knowing what you do now and seeing how the Longhorn fan base reacted to what was said to a crowd of Texas Tech fans, would you do anything differently in that moment if you were able to go back and do something differently?
Trey, I never go backwards, you know, buddy. I it's just my life. I never go backwards. I'm just looking forward to the game this weekend, embracing the passion that the Texas fans are going to have, the Oklahoma State fans are going to have, thrilled to be the commissioner of the Big 12, thrilled to be in this moment. All eyes are going to be on the Big 12 for all the right reasons at 11 o'clock Central, live on ABC, and that's what I'm focused on.
All right, appreciate that. Now, as far as the game itself on Saturday, Brett, this is a crazy year in college football because it feels like we need that expanded college football playoff this season. There are a lot of teams that have a good argument to be in the playoff this year, but there's only four slots. So I guess my question for you based on that is, assuming that at least one of the undefeated teams loses this weekend in their conference championship game and Texas does beat Oklahoma State, do you think Texas is deserving of one of those college football playoff spots as one of a handful of teams that have a single loss on the season?
Well, first of all, Trey, I'll tell you, there is a lot of parity in college football. You're absolutely right. And I'm excited about the expanded playoffs. And obviously, amongst, you know, the other commissioners, FBS commissioners, we're working hard to bring that to fruition and looking forward to it. As it relates to Texas, listen, they've had a hell of a season. Great season. One of the best wins of the season, going to Alabama earlier this year. They certainly have played really, really well within our conference and for the conference schedule. And if they win this weekend, I think they're very deserving. We certainly advocate strongly for them to be part of the CFP. They're one of the premier programs in the country, and they've shown that all season long. And I'm sure they're going to be very competitive this weekend, and we'll see what happens. But if they win this weekend, we will strongly advocate for them to be in the CFP.
Are you personally actually making calls to people on the College Football Playoff Committee saying, hey, look, Texas, their one loss is to Oklahoma. It's a rivalry game. Oklahoma was 12th ranked at the time. They also went into Tuscaloosa and did something to Alabama that hasn't happened in the Nick Saban era. I mean, are you able to actually to pick
up? Listen, as you know me, I'm always selling. Okay. So, you know, if they'll listen, I'm going to sell it. And, I think they've had a great year. Like you said, one of the biggest and biggest wins of the year on the road in, you know, at Alabama. And, if I can help, I will, certainly.
Okay. Have you spoken to Steve Sarkisian or Chris Del Conte at all this season? And if so, what was that conversation?
All the time. I saw a coach right before the game. We text. He's become a good friend. Obviously a great coach, wonderful person. And so I think I have a strong relationship with coach, and which will last beyond this season. And Chris Del Conte and I speak very often. You know, he's someone I seek guidance from, and he's terrific. Obviously, you know, one of the premier ADs in the country. So good relationship with both of them, as well as the president, Jay. And you know, we all get along really well. And, you know, obviously I'll be seeing him this weekend.
Yeah, and look, if nothing else, you are having conversations with CDC and Jay and plenty of other ADs and presidents as it relates to trying to figure out something federally with NIL and this idea of paying college athletes for name, image, and likeness, which is turning into something a little bit more, I think, in college football right now. Is there an obvious solution right now, Brett, that maybe includes something along the lines of revenue sharing? That's a topic that seems to have really come up over the last couple of weeks now with the lawsuit that the NCAA and a number of member institutions are facing. What do you see as the best potential solution right now with all of that?
Yeah, Trey, I'll keep it pretty simple on this subject, but I'll just say that I was on Capitol Hill on Monday with some of my fellow commissioners. We had great meetings. I think there's momentum on the Hill for some federal legislation, bipartisan. What I found, and this was the second time I went to Capitol Hill, a lot of people have passion for what we do, regardless of who you speak to. And I'm very optimistic. We need federal legislation, especially as it relates to a uniform standard around NIL. I think that's critically important. You know, as you are well aware of, states interpret it very differently. And, that has to be, you know, at the center of you know, what we seek from a federal level. But I think there's momentum, and I'm excited to be, you know, part of that process and representing the Big 12 in those conversations.
Do you think it's important that the collectives that are really spearheaded a lot of what is getting to college athletes right now, that it's important that they end up under the umbrella of the athletics department before it's all said and done?
Trey, I'd only say that there's a lot that we need to consider. Okay. And I think everything's under consideration on how do we modernize and contemporize college athletics. I don't want to speak to what that means today or tomorrow, but I think, you know, we're having meaningful discussions on the best path forward, and we'll continue to do that. And I think everyone needs to just trust the process, but we'll get there. And again, I'm excited about, you know, what I heard and on the Hill. And there's a lot of people that love college athletics, want to see it viable today, tomorrow, and into the future. That being said, you know, protecting student athlete rights is critically important. And I'm very optimistic we're going to find a solution that works for everyone.
Considering just how much money is being made in college football annually, I think it's north of $1.4 billion now. Does it seem like an obvious step to include revenue sharing as part of that future NIL model, at least for the sake of college football?
Trey, like I said, I don't want to get into too many specifics.
Okay.
But, you know, I think the consensus is we're going to move to a different model. You know, and as I said on the Hill, we all can do better as a collective group. And I think, you know, when we think about better, it thinks about how can we enhance benefits for student athletes. And collectively, we've got to determine what does more mean? What more can we be doing? Mm-hmm. And you know, there's a lot of people brighter than me that are thinking through that. And I do have a seat at the table, and it's a priority for all of us, and I'm optimistic we'll get to the right place.
College football is such a different beast from every other college sport. And look, you know, college basketball certainly has its place. College baseball and softball do too. But college football is on such a different level. Might it make sense at some point to separate college football from the rest of college athletics, considering how much money is on the line?
I haven't really focused on that, okay. Trey. That's not something I've been focused on, to be candid with you.
Sure. And yeah, it'll be fascinating to see how all of this plays out before it is all said and done. So
yeah, listen, we're in a very transformative moment, obviously, but I'd also say, Trey, it's an exciting time for college sports. There's lots of opportunity. There's incredible fans across the country. And, you know, I'm optimistic we're going to come up with a solution that protects student athletes, that makes college sports viable today, tomorrow, and into the future. And I'm just excited to be a part of the process.
No, no doubt about that. But it's also imperative to figure something out sooner rather than later, just because, like Matt Rhule, the head coach at Nebraska, said within the last couple of days, I mean, he was very forthright in admitting that if you want to get a good quarterback on the transfer portal right now, you have to be willing to spend north of $1 million per season in doing so, which obviously goes against what was initially thought of name, image, and likeness. But I think anybody with foresight, and I'm sure you would agree with me on this, saw that inevitably it would turn into a bit of a bidding war in situations like that as well. So it's like, you know, you have guys openly talking about that now. So hopefully those most responsible for figuring something out can get it all to come together. You create those guardrails that have been talked about for a couple of years now, and make sure that everybody's on the same page with how they're going about that business too.
Yeah, I agree. You know, we do need a consensus on what that path forward looks like. You know, because everyone's so passionate about it, you've got varying opinions, but we'll get there for sure. And one of the things we did express on the Hill earlier this week is the sense of urgency, to your point, and why this is such a priority for all of us. So again, I'm optimistic we'll get there, and we just got to keep working towards it.
Cool. All right, last question, Brett. What's been your favorite moment of this college football season?
That's a great question. You know, we've had such parity in our conference this year. Yeah. And there's been some incredible down-to-the-wire moments, especially over the last couple of weeks. I don't think there was one particular moment. You know, I become a big college football fan. You know, I growing up in the Northeast, I didn't experience it much. And when I was in Indiana, candidly, we weren't very good at that point in time in football. So I become a big fan. I enjoy being on campus. You know, each campus is different. Each environment's different. So, you know, I just enjoyed the entire season. I really did. And to your point earlier, it's gone very fast. I can't believe it's almost over. But looking forward to bowl season, obviously, but most importantly, to Saturday and our championship game.
You know, I just realized this, that you were at Indiana during a pretty good time for that basketball program. Bob Knight obviously passed away about a month or so ago. Did you have any experience or interactions with Bob Knight, either as a student or after the fact?
So, great question. I graduated Indiana in 1988. In 87, we won the national championship when Keith Smart hit that shot in the corner. I'll always remember that. I also took a class when I was at Indiana with Coach Knight. Mm. May he rest in peace. And got to know him. And then when I became the CEO of the Nets, our coach at the time, Lawrence Frank, who happened to be a fraternity brother and went to Indiana also, was a manager for the Indiana Hoosiers while he was on campus. And for the first couple of years, when I was the CEO and Lawrence was the coach, he would invite Coach Knight out at the start of the season. So after, you know, a couple of years being off campus, I got to rekindle, if you will, my relationship with Coach Knight, seeing him at, you know, some of our practices, and always enjoyed those moments.
Bob Knight is a college instructor. Was he breaking out the rule and trying to give people swats in the classroom?
Hey, listen, let me just tell you this, Trey. It was an 8 o'clock class. And as if it was yesterday, I remember him telling me, and the class on the first day of class, if you miss this class once, you go from an A to a C. If you miss it twice, don't show up because you have failed this class.
Oh, man.
So on the first day of the class, that afternoon, I went to the local drugstore and I picked up a battery-operated clock, alarm clock, and a plug-in because I was so concerned that if, God forbid, the electricity went out, that I had a backup. So I made sure I was on, you know, in that class on time because it was an 8 a.m. class. And I love the experience. You know, it was a 2-hour class and once a week. And in the morning, the first hour, we'd meet with Coach Knight. The second hour, his assistant coaches would take us onto the floor at Assembly Hall and they would simulate a practice because many of the students in the class aspired to be coaches. And it was a wonderful experience. And, you know, being a bit of a basketball fan, it was a bit of a dream come true for me as well.
Yeah. I'll say, what was the class? Something akin to coaching 101,
coaching and basketball.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So, that first hour was with Coach Knight and he talked more about life lessons than basketball, candidly. And then, you know, the second half, the assistant coaches would take you through a simulated practice. So for those that aspire to be coaches, it was great training. And like I said, I loved every minute of it. And I made sure I was in class on time.
Well, you and I value a good story, and I appreciate you sharing a really good story to end this conversation. He is Brett Yormark, commissioner of the Big 12. You will see him on Saturday attending Texas and Oklahoma State at AT&T Stadium, 11 a.m. kickoff. Brett, thank you as always for the time, man. Really appreciate it. I look forward to the next time, probably at Big 12 Media Days next summer.
Great. Will I see you this weekend?
I'm not going to be there this weekend, unfortunately, Brett, but I'm bummed about that. But I've got some family things going on this weekend. But I may try and make it up for the Big 12 basketball championships this year. If so, I'll give you guys a holler and see if we get together for a coffee or another chat like this.
Great. Trey, listen, always nice to see you. Enjoy your family this weekend, and I look forward to connecting soon.